Good afternoon, children. So today we are going to revise linear programming. Okay, linear programming problem. So tell me what all the things we have learned in linear programming. What all the terms we have learned in linear programming problem? Okay, actually linear programming, it was found during the Second World War. Okay, the main aim was to when I just went through this, I am just giving the message. Okay, actually the main aim for setting this theory was to cause the maximum loss to the enemy and minimize the cost. Okay, for that only this theory was set up. Nowadays it is used in all the fields like business, accountancy, everywhere it is used. But when it was introduced, actually it was set accordingly to plan the activity so that maximum damages will be caused to the enemy and with the minimum cost of production and all. That is all.
Ma'am.
Yes, Achyut.
Ma'am, for maths, are we submitting the record?
Record work, is it complete or not?
Yes, ma'am. Only that is there, right?
Assignment. I have given some assignments. That and all, is it ready?
No. Not completely, ma'am. I practiced it, but it's not in the fair form.
Okay, no problem. What you have practiced, you keep it together and staple it. That is enough. No need to make it fair once again.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, others? Is it right? Okay. So, linear programming problem. That is what we write it as LPP. Okay. Last time someone asked WRT. What is WRT? With respect to. Okay. Likewise, here it will be given LPP. What is meant by LPP? Linear programming problem. Linear programming problem. So, in linear programming problem, there is some optimization. Okay, we want to find either maximize or minimize. Optimal value we need. Optimal means the best. Okay, that is a so linear programming problem will be given with an objective function. Objective function, we denote this as Z. And objective function will be always a linear function. What is meant by linear function? Linear means? Yes, Naureen, Aryan, linear function means power of, yes, Naureen.
Power is one.
Degree, power is one. Okay, so optimization problem means will be given with an objective. That objective will be either maximize or minimize. That objective function is a linear function along with some constraints. Along with some constraints, some conditions. Okay, based on this condition, some restrictions only, we'll be solving this. And in all the cases, we will be getting x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0. So we will be focusing on only the first quadrant. Our solution set will be coming in the first quadrant because x is greater than or equal to 0, y is greater than or equal to 0. We consider only the first quadrant. That is about the constraints. Okay, then which are the decision variables? X, Y, Z or X, Y? Which are the decision variables? Alvin, in a linear programming problem, can you identify the decision variable?
X.
Yes, which are the decision variables?
X, Y.
X and Y. X and Y are the decision variables. Okay. So when we find the resolution, we'll be getting all the points inside that region is a solution. That region is called the feasible region. Feasible. Okay. That region is called feasible. Okay. Among this solution, we are going to find the optimal solution, best solution. Okay, actually there will be infinitely many solution, but we find the optimal solution. The optimal solution will be formed only at the corner points. We use the method of corner points. Okay, based on this, let us solve few questions. Okay, this is last year's question paper, children. Sample paper, question paper. Okay, children, look at the 38th question. Try this one. Solve the linear programming problem. Write this question and try to solve it. Maximize z is equal to x plus 2y. Subject to the constraints, x plus 2y is greater than or equal to 100. 2x minus y is less than or equal to 0. 2x plus y is less than or equal to 200. X comma y is greater than or equal to 0. Write the question. Maximize z is equal to x plus 2y subject to the constraints. X plus 2y greater than or equal to 100. 2x minus y less than or equal to 0. 2x plus y less than or equal to 200. X comma y is greater than or equal to 0. So first, find the solution set for the first one, 2x plus y, 2x minus y less than or equal to 0. Consider that as equal to 0. Find the solution set. When x is 0, y is also 0, isn't it? You keep it in mind. Whenever there is no constant term in a linear equation, no constant term means it will pass through the origin. Then, when x is 1, when x is 1, what is the value of y? Y will be 2. Is it correct, Sanya?
Yes, ma'am.
Now find the solution set for the next one. X plus 2y is equal to 100. And the next one is 2x plus y equal to 200. Find the solution set. X plus 2y is equal to 100. Diya, can you give the solution set for the second one? X plus 2y is equal to 100.
X 0. Y 50.
Okay. Y 0. X is 100. Okay. Srihari, solution set of the next one, 2x plus y is equal to 200.
X is 0, y is 200.
Okay.
Then y is 0, x is 100.
Okay. So now based on this, you draw the graph. Okay. Draw the graph. So it's x dash, y dash. Now when x is 0, y is 0. If I take the first one, x is 1, y is 2. So it will be passing like this. You have to identify, select the region, isn't it? Try this one and find the region first. Find the region. And what about the corner points?
Ma'am.
Yes.
How will we take the units?
Units, what it is roughly only you need, isn't it? If you take 100, 10, 10 units, here you want 100 and all. So what you can do, you can take 10 units or you can take 20 units. If you take 20 units, 20, 40, 60. You look at the value given there. Maximum value we need is 100. Similarly for y, maximum value we need is 200. So you can take 50 or 100. Along x-axis we can take 20 units. Along y-axis we can take 50. Is it okay, Achyut?
Yes, ma'am.
And here 192 means it will be very closer to it. X is 0, y is 0, x is 1, y is 2 means very closer. So you'll be getting almost a line passing through the origin. Based on the maximum value of x, you select the scale. Similarly, based on the maximum value of y. Because we need only the corner points. Okay, we need only the corner points. Now look at the second one. Now before that, what about the region here? Is it below the line or above the line? Nandana, for the first one, 2x minus y. Is it below the line or above the line? Yes, Nandana? Gayatri, tell me Gayatri, is it above the line or below the line? Is it above the line or below the line, Gayatri?
Above the line.
Above the line. It is above the line. When you put 0, okay, if you put the point 20, 0, if you substitute it, you can understand. When you put 20, 0, so 2 into 20, 40 is less than or equal to 0. Is it satisfying? No. That means above the line. Now similarly take the next one. X plus 2y is equal to 100. When x is 0, y is 50. X is 100, 0. So we'll be getting a line like this. And this line is given by x plus 2y. X plus 2y equal to 100. Here also you have to find, is it above or below? Aditya, is it above the line or below the line?
Ma'am. Above.
Above, okay. So here also we get the region above. Then take the third case. X is 0, y is 200. And x is 100, 0. So this is the line. 2x plus y is 200. Now for this, is it above or below? Ashwin, is it above the line or below the line, Ashwin? Ashwin. Is it above the line or below the line? Krishnachandran.
Below the line.
Below the line. So which is our region here? Okay, we'll be getting below the line. So our region will be Shade it. Okay, shade it and check your region. Is it correct? So just below this line. So this is our region. So this is our region. Is it correct? Check it, children. Okay. Are you getting like this? This is our region. So we have to find the corner points. Which are the corner points? We'll get four corner points here. It is a bounded region, isn't it? Bounded region. If it is bounded only, we'll be getting a solution. What are the corner points here? Michael, give the corner points. Suppose we name the corner points as A, B, C, D. So what about the point A? You identify the point A, point B, point C and D.
0, 200.
Very good. 0, 200. B, point B.
0, 50.
0, 50. Point C. We have to solve the equations. Okay, we have to solve the equations. Which two okay. The equations are 2x minus y is 0 and the other one is 2x plus y, isn't it? That is that equation. 2x plus y, isn't it correct? X plus 2y is 100 or 2x plus y, 200. X is 0. C is the point given by x plus 2y is equal to 100. So we can multiply the first equation by 2. So 4x minus 2y is equal to 0. So we get 5x equal to 100. X is equal to 20. If x is 20, what is y? Y is 40. X is 20. Y is 40. So the point C is 20, 40. Similarly, find out the point D. Find the point D. Dia, give the point D, Dia.
X is 50.
X is 50. And y is
100.
100. 2x minus y is 0. The other equation is 2x plus y is equal to 200. So we'll get 4x equal to, so x is 50. Y is 100, yes. So now we have the corner points. Substitute in the objective function. Which is our objective function? Z is equal to x plus 2y. Substitute in the objective function and find out what is the maximum value. What is the maximum value? Calculate and give the answer.
A.
Yes, is it at the point A, B, C or D?
Point A.
At A you are getting maximum. What about Gauri?
I'm calculating.
Okay.
A, ma'am.
At the A. And what is the maximum value?
400.
400, yes. Okay, so the maximum value is 400 and it occurs at 0,200. The value occurs at 0,200. Okay. Is it okay? Alvin, Ashwin, Shivani, linear programming, easily we can score. It's not a very tough part. It's an easy one only. You have to draw the graph. From the graph, we have to find out the corner points. Okay. Once you get the corner points, substitute it in the objective function. If maximize is asked, means you have to select the maximum value. Minimize is asked, means you have to select the minimum value. So the first part, is it clear, children? The first part, is it okay? Sania?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the maximum value?
A.
Maximum value is?
400.
Okay. Now try the second question. Okay. I hope you completed this one. Okay. Now look at the second part. Try to solve this one. Read this one and try to solve this one. Here, graph is given. Okay, it's being, nowadays we are writing one more question. The question will be like this. Graph will be given. From the graph, you have to find out. So read this question and answer this one. Corner points are given, isn't it? How many corner points are here, Achyut? How many corner points are there in this graph? Seven.
Six.
Yes, it is six. Okay, O is 0, 0, A, B, C, D, E. Six corner points are there. Now, substitute this and find out what is the maximum and what is the minimum value. Yes, Gauri, give me the values at the corner points, Gauri.
A, negative 32.
Negative 32. What about at B?
Negative 28.
Negative 28. Sania, at C?
Negative 12.
Negative 12. Okay. Michael, at D?
Negative 2.
Negative 2. Rijas, at the point E.
12.
Now answer the questions. Okay, once you find out the corner values and once you identify the corner points, answer the remaining. Find the maximum and minimum value of set. Yes, Achyut?
We have to give 0 also, right?
Yes, you have to give 0 also. So when you give 0, you'll get 0. You have to substitute all the corner points. Then find the maximum and the minimum value of Z. Also the corresponding points at which the maximum and minimum value occurs. Srihari, what is the maximum value?
Well,
12. And it occurs at 4,0, isn't it? Naureen, what is the minimum value, Naureen?
Minus 32.
And it occurs at
0,8.
It occurs at 0,8. Okay, hope you all completed this one. This question, is it over? Yes, Atul, Alvin?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Okay, so this is this year's sample paper. Okay, you're going to solve the questions from linear programming. Now try to answer this question, children. Okay, is it clear? The figure, is it okay?
Can I enlarge?
Is it okay? Now is it clear? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Now try to solve this one, 19th one. Shaded region is given and you are asked to identify at which point you will get maximum. Find out and give the answer. Okay, do this. I'll mark your address. At the corner points, what is the value? What is the value at the corner points? Alvin, at A, what is the value, Alvin? Alvin, at A, what's the value? where you have to substitute in this objective function, isn't it? You substitute it, what is the answer? Yes, Nia, tell me, Nia, at 0, 10. Nia, what is the value at 0, 10? Easily we can calculate. Alvin, if you are ready, give the answer, 90. Alvin. 90, yes. Now, Nia, do the second one. Answer the second one. At the point B, what is the maximum value? At the point B. Nia, okay. Aryan, at 5, 5. What 60. Is the value?
60.
At C, 15, 15. At C, 15, 15. Atul, at 15, 15?
180.
Naureen, at 0, 20?
180.
So what will be the answer? What will be the answer, Nandana?
D.
Okay, we have 2 points and CD is the line segment. So, every point on the line segment CD. Okay, every point on the line segment CD. If the same value occurs at 2 endpoints, so along the same line, you'll be getting the same value. So, at every point on the line segment CD. Okay, is it clear, children? Shall we do the next one? I think a similar question. Okay, similar to the previous one. Okay, try the 23rd question. Try this one, 23rd question. In the given graph, the feasible region for LPP is shaded. The objective function is z is equal to 2x minus 3y will be minimum at. You are asked to find the minimum. Corner points are given, substitute it and find the. So this questions and all we can score easily, is that no? So in the exam, when you get such type of questions, you answer that one. Okay, which are all easy questions, you answer it in the beginning itself. Attempt as many questions. Okay, so in the beginning itself, once you get the question paper, what do you have to do? When you are reading, during the reading time, you note down the easy questions and do it in the beginning. Okay. So this LPP part is always an easy one. Give the answer. Find out what is the minimum value and find that. Yes, Sania, can you give the value, Sania, at 0, 8?
Minus 24.
Minus 24. Okay. Emmanuel, at 4, 10. At 4, 10.
28.
28. Positive or negative?
No, 28.
Is it 28?
No, ma'am. 22.
22. Is it positive or negative?
Negative.
Negative. Okay. Aryan, at 6,8.
Negative 12.
Yes, correct. Negative 12. Aditya, at 6,5.
Minus 3.
Minus 3. Then. Srihari, at 5,0.
10.
10. And at 0, it is 0, isn't it? And the question is minimum value. What is the minimum value? Atul.
0,8.
Minimum value is minus 24 and it occurs at 0,8. So option is C, isn't it? Option is C. Okay. Shall we move on to the next one? Is it complete? Okay, now try that. Let's try this one, children. 33rd question. Question number 33. A linear programming is as follows. Minimize z is equal to 30x plus 50y subject to the constraints. So in the feasible region, the minimum value of z occurs at, is it a unique point, no point, infinitely many points, or 2 points only? So draw the graph. You have to find the graph, find the solution set. Then find out the corner points, substitute the values and check at how many points you will get the solution. At how many points you will be getting minimum. The solution means here we want minimum, not the maximum. Is it 1 point or 2 points? Draw the graph and give the answer. Okay. And one more question, children. That one also I want to discuss it. Okay. See, for hope you are all having the sample paper with you, isn't it? So note down this in your sample paper. 40, question number 41 is very important. Question number 41 is very important. That model, we have another question in our textbook. Miscellaneous exercise we have. One mark question in miscellaneous exercise. Okay, we have one mark question. That is also an important one. Gauri, if you have the page number, please give the page number. It's an MCQ question based on PQ. Not having the textbook with me. In your textbook. You have the textbook, second volume. Or otherwise, okay. After the class, I'll send the question number. Similar question, one based on P and Q. P is equal to 3Q, like that one question is there. Are you able to find that? Next. One more question. Choose the best answer. Yes, which one? Yes, Gauri. Give the question number and page number.
Page number 520, question number 11.
Question number 11. Note down, children. Note it. Page number 520, question number 11. That is also an important question. Try these questions. Okay. Try these questions. We'll be discussing in the next class. Try these questions. Go through it and come with the answer. Be ready with the answer before the class. Okay. And tomorrow we'll be writing the test paper in application of derivatives. Prepare well. Okay. And wind up today. Thank you. Thank you.